It's already snowing, and one of America's premier weather forecasters is warning that for parts of the U.S., another bad winter is on the way.
It's going to be a major winter for much of the eastern and southern part of the United States. We think it's a formidable winter, but the core of the worst cold relative to averages, instead of being in the northern plains and Midwest, will be further south and east.
Last winter was bad too, historically bad. The Great Lakes weren't ice-free until June, when the Mountain West was still seeing snow. But the UN keeps warning us that if we don't do something to stop global warming, the end is near.
The report confirms that the effects of human-caused climate change are already widespread and consequential.
But what effects from climate change? The Earth stopped warming 18 years ago, and the weather has made a mockery of climate change predictions. The number of extreme weather events are down. Sea levels are not rising dangerously. And not only is Antarctic ice not melting, it's the largest it's been since measurements began 35 years ago. But world leaders, including our president, still act like climate change is a serious problem.
Climate change is already affecting Americans all across the country, in every region, although in different ways.
This is called a climate scream. It's similar to a primal scream, except it's done by radical environmentalists demanding world leaders do something to stop climate disaster. But the real disaster has been the inaccuracy of all those scary predictions that didn't come true.
By last count, there were 42 separate explanations in the scientific or public literature on why it hasn't been warming. When there are 42 explanations for some one phenomenon, I can tell you what that means. Scientists don't know what they're talking about. There's a real problem with the computer models for climate change.
Why has the Earth stopped warming? One reason, cooler surface temperatures in the Pacific.
One of the major cycles of the Earth, the Pacific Decadal Oscillation, which is a temperature cycle in the North Pacific Ocean, it's gone into cool phase about 2005. The sun has moved into a cool phase in terms of sunspots.
WeatherBell's Joe Bastardi is forecasting a long-term trend toward colder temperatures.
Over the next 20 to 30 years, I think the general trend is down back towards where it was in the late 70s.
The 1970s was when some were warning of a coming ice age. Yet President Obama thinks the problem of global warming is so urgent, he's reportedly been plotting to make an international climate deal without gaining U.S. Senate approval as required by the Constitution. But the president may be lonely when he attends next week's climate summit in New York. A number of world leaders aren't coming. Perhaps they're afraid of looking silly. Dale Hurd, CBN News.